ситуация на крупный банк, украинский рынок, Raiffeisen Bank Aval. So, I will speak in English and Russian. Please stop me if you don't understand. So now you had a picture of a software provider. I will now provide you a picture of Ukrainian bank and how CRM works in our bank. So, my understanding and my experience is that in Ukraine, CRM is a relatively new concept, and specifically for Ukrainian banks. The best CRM entities in Ukraine are telecom, Kyivstar, MTS. They do it much better because they have tons of data. They know how to work with information, customer behaviors. Ukrainian banks are far behind, and we are also, so I admit that we're far behind. We have a long way to go, not only in systems, but how we approach CRM. And I think a good indication is, if you look at the cross-sell, based on the Raiffeisen countries, 15 Central Eastern European, Russia, Belarus also, you can see that we're not even halfway between the number of products per customer as we have in Central Eastern Europe. So this means that we have a bit to catch up, a big way to catch up with our colleagues in Central Eastern Europe. I don't even put Western Europe there. We just around, I think, 4 or 5 products, if I may remember. So the situation with CRM and has to be adapted to the environment. And as we know today, the environment for lending is very difficult. There are very, very many things that are not known. The future is unexpected, devaluation, change of parliaments, borrowers, solvency, all of those issues that we deal with every day. But this has a direct impact because CRM today in our banks is solely concentrated on lending. There's not one bank that has an event management system where you're able to offer at the point of sale other products than lending. At least I know. So this means that we have a difficult environment to work with CRM. We have more information now than we ever have in the last 2 or 3 years about borrowers. We have credit bureaus, we have blacklists, we have databases, we share. So the number of customers is shrinking. This makes an additional challenge for CRM. So for us, in Aval, what is CRM and what are the benefits that we look at? So it's one place where we control the communication with all our customers. It's the central point of how we look at our customers and offer our products. Second, which probably is the most important, 100% of our CRM activities, our offers to customers for loan products, are pre-approved. So a customer is offered an amount, credit limit, predetermined. So we offer it to him, send them through the mail, SMS, at the branch. He either gets that amount, or that's the maximum he will receive. So there's no discussion with the customer on how much he wants, because he knows exactly when he comes to the branch how much he will receive from us. Cutting the cost. CRM plays a big part in reducing your marketing spend. For us, I have a very small above-the-line marketing budget, and I don't need it because I focus all my marketing money on CRM, on my cross-sell activities. Much cheaper, as you know, to buy TV ads, which have gone dramatically up. It's cheaper to do a direct mail for 3 or 4 euros or 3 or 4 hryvnia than to run multiple campaigns for 5, 10 million hryvnia per shop. For let's say 2 marketing campaigns, full blown with I would say probably 10 to 15 million. For 10 to 15 million, I can do hundreds of thousands of direct mails. And the contact is much higher than I would by putting that 10 or 15 million out for above the line marketing. Segmentation. I think this is the one thing that we all seem to forget about because we concentrate solely on the IT part of it, but not about the customer data. You cannot have a CRM system without having customer data and knowing who your customers are and what to sell them. So banks tend to forget about this. And this is a huge task for any bank who has done CRM successfully, is to prepare the data and prepare the offers for the customer. Because you can buy a multi-million dollar system, but if you don't have your back end fixed and your customer segmentation, the system won't work. You won't get your value out of it. Therefore, we've invested over the last 3 years a huge amount of money in segmentation, time, effort, to know our customers, what transactions they do, their behaviors. And we've been using very simple, you can find it in any consultant's presentations, how to look at our customers, and we break it into four boxes, yeah. Therefore, our CRM strategies are targeted specifically for each set of customers. And we know what our customers look like in each of the boxes. And in segment A, these are our cross-sell potential high value who are underserved today and who need to be pushed over to segment B. And as you can see, for the last year and a half, we've increased our segment B customers in terms of profitability, in terms of numbers, by 60%. That's a huge amount because, as you can imagine, put 4 or 5 million customers into these various boxes, 60% in any of the boxes is a huge leap. Additionally, our worst customers, indeed, these are customers that bring negative value to the bank. The cost of service is less than the revenue generated. We use CRM to push them out of the bank. Yes, we do push customers out of the bank. We've been quite successful. 40% of these customers in the last year and a half have left the bank. Might seem like a strange strategy, but if a customer is bringing negative value to you as a bank, why will you continue to serve them? If the cross-sell potential for this customer is very, very limited, why do you have them in your branches? Standing in line with a customer who is affluent, premium, who has money. So therefore, segmentation is very important. It's the building block of successful CRM. No matter what system you have. Everybody's seen this slide. It's in the standard marketing materials of any textbook. It's the customer life cycle. Well, I would like to show you how this is applicable to CRM and how we use it. Over the life cycle of a customer, CRM has to be a key part of how we attack this customer, how we bring this customer into the bank, how we onboard him, how we cross-sell him, how we retain him, how we retain him, and eventually, how the customer leaves the bank, how the attrition. This is a main focus for us, and we track, as you remember, the four segments, we track this per segment. We know who's coming, who's going, when we need to attack them. We have timelines for each customer, what product to tell them, what product to sell them. Unfortunately, we have not been successful, and I think only over time will we get to an event-based CRM. How many of you know what event-based CRM means? So every time that a customer does a transaction, you track his behavior. And as the colleague from Pentagy said, when somebody in the branch comes in, the system creates an event, or the customer creates an event, and if the behavior is over a period of transactions or time, CRM will say, this customer needs this product. For instance, You make four payments to a supplier or to Volacable. The same amount every month for 3 months or 4 months. The system will pop up and say, sell this customer direct debit or standing order. Because he's doing it, he's making the same amount of payment every month. And the customer will not need to come into the branch anymore. The money will be automatically deducted. And that's an event-based CRM trigger. That's probably something that all big banks aspire to and want to do, but it's a bit down the road, and I think only in the more developed banks who have the technology first, who have the capability, and who have the transactional behavior, cataloged, put in a data mart, easy to understand, and then you build this event tree, and it triggers them. Our international, let's say our internet banking subsidiary for Raiffeisen International that operates in 3 or 4 countries now, has 100 events in their event tree which triggers an action for a customer or a promo for a customer. I think it's important to understand the difference between analytical CRM and operational CRM. We all, in discussions, it's a common mistake, we tend to confuse them. And when we talk, most time people only talk about operational CRM, what happens at the branch level. But to tell you, in all honesty, the most important for me is analytical CRM. It's the least talked about because it's the least understood. If you're not a mathematician, if you're not know how to manipulate thousands and millions of records, it's just, I don't understand it. Please tell me about this, yeah. But this drives it. If you don't have this, you cannot have successful CRM. It's the corners, it's another building block. And it requires, as colleagues have said, across the bank, focus, attention, and commitment. That means IT, operations, business, and risk management. Because when you're doing cross-sell for credit products, CRM, risk management plays a vital role in making sure that all of the requirements according to the credit policy are adhered to. In 2012, we plan to do 205 campaigns, CRM campaigns, direct to their customers. 7 million contacts through 7 channels. So we use 7 channels, primarily these right here. Direct mail, SMS, ATMs, internet banking, email. We're touching our customers 7 million times. Different times, different products, different ways of doing it. Our best in class banks in Raiffeisen across all of our countries is upwards of 20 million. But for 20 million contacts, you need to have a lot of customers. Because one thing that we found, that customers don't like to be bombarded with SMSs, direct mails, constantly. Because that means the bank is pushing the product, which is not interesting to a customer. The customer wants products which they are interested in. So what is important? What are relatively easy things to do for us, the CRM? Credit is very easy. We've now, after 3 years of doing CRM, we think we're quite good at it in terms of doing personal loans, credit cards, overdrafts, and as I said, 100% of our cross-sell campaigns are pre-approved. We do it also for packages, for debit cards, and we do it for commission products, transactional. daily banking services, transfers, Western Union. We do what is called CLIP. This is a credit line increase program for credit cards. So we are increasing people's credit card limits automatically throughout various parts of their life cycle, depending on how well they spend, where they spend. We're doing probably 100,000 increases every quarter and plan to do much, much more in the future. Top-ups are a big part of our program. It's about loyalty. It's about stickiness of the customer. I'm not sure, though, those of you know what a top-up is. It's when you get a personal loan, and after a certain period of time, 1 year, year and a half, customer's paying down, you go back to them and say, we want to increase your limit, or offer you another loan, another 20,000 hryvnia, preferential rate. The customer then takes a new loan and extends it for another period of time. For personal loans, this is I would call hygiene. This is a basic part of any personal loan process in any international bank. The most difficult to do for CRM is premium banking or affluent banking, VIP banking, investment products. We have not been successful, and it's very difficult, and we're not at the, because it requires a more customized, more individual approach where a manager needs to discuss with the customer. Mortgages also are not a good, I would say, in Ukraine, they're not a good CRM activity today. Success in other Central and Eastern European countries for CRM with mortgages has been successful, but basically it's focused primarily on transactional business and unsecured credit. My personal opinion, and we set up marketing and CRM together as one entity under one Nechani Group of the Union. I think this is important. I think this is important for these three reasons. Yeah, I know in some banks they separate them for whatever reasons. For me, by putting the communication to the customer in one hand, one person responsible, eliminates conflicting messages to customers. I've seen banks, not only here and other places, do marketing campaigns with a different message than the CRM campaigns, cross-sell different ideas, and this creates confusion for customers. We also bring continuity, simplicity to this function. If it's concentrated in one hand, we are able to save money, we're able to concentrate all the resources within these two teams, and they have a common objective. Because the CRM, direct marketing focus, communication strategy, has to be in line with the marketing strategy, not only of the bank, but in specifically retail. This is a campaign, so just to give you an understanding of a pre-approved, the marketing campaign, and what's important is we track the conversion rate and to measure the success of these campaigns. And if you're not doing this, you're not doing CRM, or you're not to measure it. You're not understanding how successful you are and how successful you can be. And a 13.5% conversion rate for a direct mailing campaign, I think in any international bank you would say that's wide, that's, I think, in best in class. Now that could be related to the hunger of Ukrainians for unsecured loans, or it could be related to the effectiveness of how we specifically target customers. Yeah. Last year, in 2011, 60,000 credit cards were sold only by CRM. So CRM does the leads, drives the customers into the branch, and the branch converts them and signs the documents. So we say this is a CRM sale, not a branch sale. Branch is just the last part of the chain where the customer signs the documents. It's important to help you understand that the difference between CRM-driven sales and branch-driven sales. And this is where you will probably, those of you who know me, you'll have many hot discussions on whose sale is it. Does the branch get credit for it, or CRM? How do you separate these? How does the branch work with CRM? Is the branch able to contact the customer? We have very strict rules in place about customer contact, who can contact the customer, and when to contact the customer. Primarily today in our bank is driven by CRM. Branches are not allowed to contact the customer for sales. This is very strict, I know, and it might sound strange, but you have to enforce the discipline for CRM to be effective. If not, you can imagine. One day, the call center calls. The next day, he receives a direct mail. The next day, the branch calls him. What is the customer supposed to think? The crazy bank's calling me, sending me, stop calling me every day. They don't know what they're doing. Huh? So therefore, having a proper plan how CRM integrates into the branch in its sales environment is, I think, a prerequisite for success, because you create confusion if you don't. For 2012, for the first 5 months, 200 million just from top-ups for cross-sell for unsecured. For the cross-sell, 400 million. We've sold 100,000 credit cards in the first 5 months, only through cross-sell. This is to existing customers. There's no walk-ins. There's not any walk-ins in these numbers. It's all existing customers. Our strategy today in our bank is to focus only on internal customers. For the first 4 months of the year, we didn't allow any walk-ins. We rejected walk-in applications. So you have to be a customer of the bank through a salary relationship or a private relationship to apply for a loan or to get a loan. Only starting in May, or late April, did we allow walk-ins. And you can imagine we do this for various reasons. Risk, concentration, because of course, we know our customers better if they bank with us. And the risk numbers show it. They have a huge impact related to existing customers. In addition, I have little marketing spend on ATL. As I said, I spend all the money on CRM campaigns. So based on that strategy, 98% or 96% of our credit cards are sold through CRM, 80% of the personal loans. If you look at Raiffeisen in our 15 countries, best practice numbers and how it relates, 50% of credit cards are sold through the branch, 50% or 80% is sold through the CRM, 20% in the branch. For unsecured, 50%. So we are far, far above, only because we don't, for the first 4 months, we didn't lend to walk-ins. So for us, the CRM has to work like a machine to deliver these type of results, and the previous slide. And I think that, I will never say that I'm extremely happy with our results, and I think we have a long way to go. And the industry itself, in terms of banking, with CRM, has a long way to go. But there are three or four banks in Ukraine who are showing the ability and desire and willingness and have the capabilities to do CRM effectively as any other bank in Western or Central Europe.